It's way too hot. It's too hot in Phoenix. Like, I don't know how people do it. 11-hour drive to Odessa, Texas, which should be long but fun. A lot of podcasts, a lot of pit stops, a lot of fun.
Drills that you would do would be spot three objects.
Is there ice cream?
No.
No, they're like mint. It's like eating mint chocolate chip ice cream.
Interesting.
Well,
That's a lot of mint.
No, I have to eat it.
Tastes like chocolate toothpaste.
And also, this movie takes place during allergy season.
Pit stop number 3,432.
I love this truck stop. We have an assortment of hats, different hats to get them. The best part is the Gladiator, which I kind of want to get John one just because. But, I don't know, $80 is worth it. You may have to have it.
I think it's gone. My first thought is a very selfish one.
Made it to Dallas.
Oh, shit.
It almost killed my drummer.
Party in the hotel room.
See, most rock stars after a show get wasted, bring groupies back. We, on the other hand, order 2 30-inch pizzas, get some beer, and just watch a movie in the hotel room. It's rock and roll in 2017.
Soundcheck tune in Dallas.
Now your ghost haunting me every day, changing my every way. From afar,
Dallas was amazing. Energy was amazing. And then we got some serious pizza, which we'll insert a photo here where how big that pizza is, 31 inches. So it's like the size of a tractor trailer tire. It was huge. And if you don't put pineapple on your pizza, then I don't know you.
We signed to Epitaph in the hopes of getting the record out to more people.
Okay. Got it, thank you.
It's gonna be cutting close here and Austin. There was a little mishap with load-in, but we have about 22 minutes before showtime. I don't know what it's gonna be like, but it'll be a show.
Rock and roll,
rock and roll
man.
Show.
Houston, Texas. I think this is our last date in Texas, which it's been a really, really good run these past few shows. A little scary at sometimes, like now that I'm feeling like, oh, we're really on tour now. Like it's hitting us as I'm feeling tired after certain shows, trying to get some rest, but it's, like I said, it's been a learning experience. Like this is a very tough month. It's scary, like going on this tour, because I already start thinking, like, what's gonna happen after this? What do I do next? And it's easy to just fall into a routine of, okay, wake up, play a show, wake up, play a show, wake up, play a show. I don't know. There's something about being on the road that just makes me feel more at home than actually being at home, being with the guys, you know, being able to go out and meet new people every night. Like, I don't do that in New York City. I stay home in my apartment and I work, and it seems like I'm living more of my life on the road happily than I am at home. I'm learning slowly that being scared isn't necessarily a bad thing, but being fearful is. It's the best education I could get, and watching Betty every night is great. I absorb everything she's doing just to kind of pick it apart and see, you know, her success. Like, this is the time where I kind of log my hours so that a few years from now, when I'm headlining my own shows, and I know exactly what to expect. Every venue, it's a lot, especially it just being us and our, you know, 5-guy team. But again, super gratifying, exhausting, but it's probably the best summer I've had in my whole life.